We are working on mechanization of conservation cropping systems in Burkina Faso in West Africa. These young animals are being trained and will be used next year for tillage, planting, and other project work. Deanda Sedu is using low-stress training techniques to develop oxen that will be responsive and handy to work. One of our goals is to reduce the drudgery of hand labor while reducing tillage intensity to improve soil health, conserve water, and reduce the heavy load on the animals from conventional plowing. We're using the zone tillage tool to prepare rip lines, tilled zones about 6 to 8 inches wide for planting. The rolling basket levels and firms the soil in the planting zone. Corn is typically planted by hand. These young girls are placing 2 seeds every 16 inches. This type of planter has been around for many years, but it has not been widely accepted because of the relatively high cost and often poor performance. These planters were designed for conventional tillage, so we made several modifications to improve performance in minimally tilled soil. Our goal is to place a single seed every 8 inches rather than 2 seeds every 16 inches. We designed a new seed furrow opener to cut through the firm soil in the stale seed bed and control the depth of seed placement in firm soil. We changed from a concave to a convex shaped press wheel to provide more localized seed firming in the less tilled soil. We're working with 5 local blacksmiths to improve the planters, cultivators, and other equipment. The blacksmiths live among the farmers, they repair and build their equipment, and they understand the problems. They will continue the process of equipment innovation long after we are gone. We are using row cultivation for weed control. This 5-tine row cultivator is common in the region. But our farmer cooperator did not like it because the components were too close together and it had a tendency to plug. He preferred this 3-tine cultivator even though the 6-inch shovels did not provide full width cutting. It relied on throwing soil to smother small weeds rather than root cutting. Farm tools must be able to be built by local artisans with locally available materials. We worked with Zongo, the local blacksmith, to build these 12-inch sweeps from salvaged high-carbon steel leaf springs for durability and long life. They had a low crown and low-pitched wings for good soil flow and a level surface. These sweeps are designed to run just below the soil surface and undercut the weeds with little soil disturbance. Mm-hmm.
Est-ce que abon e ya mina?
Abon do na waka abichugo mina.
Idris.
Kwa
kwa kwa ati don duguma ko jugo.
Et puis abi.
Oh. Ati.
Abi chamancha.
Voilà, abi bin be sa ma konkelen katoka.
Compared to the earlier cultivator shovels, these new sweeps have several advantages. They increase the effective cutting width about 20%. They decrease the pulling force by 21%, so the animals can do the same amount of work with less effort, or they can work longer with the same effort. They had greater stability and were easier to operate, and they provided better weed control and left the soil surface level. We set up a corn wheel to learn more about the effects of plant spacing and density on corn growth and yield. The corn was planted in the shape of a wagon wheel with the corn rows as the spokes. Some rows were planted with doubles every 16 inches, others with single seeds every 8 inches. The rows had a very wide spacing at the perimeter and converged to a very narrow spacing near the wheel hub. The corn wheel demonstrates the effects of plant population density ranging from about one half of normal at the wheel perimeter to nearly three times the normal population, about 2 meters from the wheel hub. We will track crop progress through harvest.